right, well, behind me is the Eads Bridge. It's the first railroad bridge, first bridge of any kind to cross the Mississippi at St. Louis. Eads was a pretty fascinating character. He came to St. Louis with his family when he was about 13, and when the steamboat pulled into port, the boiler exploded, and 8 people died on this boat. Eads and his family had to be fished out of the river. So there's a kind of an urban legend, I don't know if it's true or not, that Eads built the bridge at the spot where he washed ashore. He went on to, I think, almost on a mission to master the river in many different ways. He founded a salvage company when he was in his early 20s, invented a diving bell that allowed him to go deep underwater and walk on the bottom of the Mississippi River in search of steamboats that have crashed, their cargo, and he even designed a specific boat that allowed him to pull up some very heavy objects from the river from these steamboat crashes. So by his 30s, he was a very rich man. His salvage business was successful. He spent hours and hours and hours walking on the bottom of the Mississippi, sometimes 60 feet below the surface of the water, and feeling the currents moving around him as he's walking around on the bottom. He probably knew the river more intimately than anybody of his generation, and maybe even more so than anybody today. When the Civil War broke out, Eads was approached to see if he could come up with a way to equip boats that would be sturdier, that would provide a more of a weapon for the Union to use on the Mississippi River. So he found a way to attach a steel frame to wooden-hulled boats. And it made them very difficult to take out. You know, cannonballs tended to bounce off those thick steel frame.
A depth of 35 feet is maintained at all times from Baton Rouge to the Gulf of Mexico, so that deep draft ocean vessels can make an easy passage to the lower river ports.
The mouth of the Mississippi historically was a difficult area to navigate. After the Civil War, New Orleans, you know, the port of New Orleans was looking for a more reliable way to get ships into its port, which is 100 miles from the mouth of the river. There were shifting sandbars. A lot of times it was clogged with debris from, you know, driftwood and trees that washed down the river. And there were different ideas floated for how to make a channel deep enough for ocean-going vessels to get up to New Orleans. Eads thought it could be done cheaper and easier if you just put the power of the river to use. So he designed jetties that focused the current of the river itself to dig out a channel deep enough for boats to get through. And he made a deal with the government that if it didn't work, they didn't have to pay him anything. So he took a big risk, he took a big financial risk and put his reputation on the line, but he believed, based on his intimate knowledge with the river, that he could harness that power and make it work, and it did.